This episode was sponsored by Google Science Fair. A near-perfect sphere of hot plasma with a core that's more than 15 million degrees Celsius, the sun is the most important source of energy for life on Earth. But what if it suddenly disappeared for a month? We were actually inspired to think about this question by the Google Science Fair, which is an online global competition for sharing your best ideas using science, technology, engineering, or math. I mean, without the sun, we'd be requiring some pretty extreme innovations to survive. If you're between the ages of 13 to 18 and have an idea that you think could help shape our world, no matter how big or small, unique or improving on an existing idea, you could win an educational scholarship, travel experiences, or tons of other prizes, so stick around at the end of this video for more details. Now, after the sun disappears, for the first 8 minutes and 20 seconds, we'd all be completely oblivious, as that's how long it takes the sun's light to hit Earth. Of course, if it was nighttime where you live, the moon would suddenly disappear as its brightness is simply a reflection of the sun's light. All that's left is the natural light from stars. Luckily, right now, we can still support our electrical systems because 83% of our world's energy comes from oil, coal, and natural gas. Now, because gravity travels at the speed of light too, it would also take 8 minutes and 20 seconds for Earth to feel the effects of the sun's disappearance. Without the sun's gravitational pull, we'd fly out of orbit and into space. But without the light of the sun, all plant photosynthesis would stop immediately. This is a big deal, as we need plants for food and oxygen. In order to survive, plants need light energy to turn carbon dioxide and water into glucose and oxygen. Without the sun, plants could still photosynthesize with artificial light, allowing us to grow food, but these artificial lights could only cover a fraction of the food produced by the sun. Currently, indoor farming accounts for 0.07% of agriculture, meaning food production would go into crisis. After a week, natural plant life would start decomposing, bringing on the collapse of our entire food web. But another concern is CO2. Decomposition of organic carbon, like plants and animals, accounts for 90% of carbon dioxide already. Without living plants to uptake that CO2, the atmospheric concentration would skyrocket. CO2 in low concentrations is a physiologically important gas, but at high concentrations is toxic. At 1% of our air, you'd become drowsy, but greater than 10% would lead to convulsions, coma, and death. As for oxygen, although the brain can only survive 6 minutes without it, our atmosphere carries about 1 quintillion kilograms of oxygen, which researchers approximate could last us at least 1,000 years. But within the same week, the planet's surface temperature would drop to around minus 18 degrees Celsius, which is survivable for now. Some Inuit communities already survive Arctic winters that are minus 25 degrees C at the warmest point of the day, and some animals can survive minus 60 degrees Celsius. But the universe is a large and cold place, where the ambient temperature of space is around minus 273 degrees Celsius, meaning it's only going to get colder and colder. After a month, assuming the same speed as our current orbit, we'll have traveled 78 million kilometers, putting us past Mars, but not as far as Jupiter. This may leave us still within what is known as the circumstellar habitable zone, the orbital range around a star that allows for enough light and heat to support liquid water. So, what would happen if after a month the sun suddenly switched back on? Assuming we haven't crashed into any other planets or had their own gravity impact our trajectory, we're now roughly 170 million kilometers from the sun. And it turns out our velocity isn't quite fast enough to escape the sun's gravity at this distance, so we'd be pulled back into an elliptical orbit, though a much wider one than before. By most scientific estimates, we're still within the habitable zone, and by congregating around areas that are volcanically and geologically active like Iceland and Yellowstone, we could harness the power of our molten core to make up for the increased distance from the sun to keep us warm. But if the sun had taken a few more months to turn on, we'd be too far to be pulled back into orbit and would become a rogue planet. Though most planets are tethered to the star that created them, studies estimate that within the Milky Way, there are 100 billion planets that wander the galaxy as rogue planets. Whichever the case for Earth, we'd require a lot of human innovation to survive.
Thanks again to Google Science Fair for sponsoring this video. If you are between 13 and 18 and you have an idea that could impact the world, make sure you go to googlesciencefair.com.
Maybe you have the idea for alternative energy sources, or thought of a way to reduce waste, or just even asked the question, could an alarm clock wake you up without making sound? The deadline to submit your project is December 12th, 2018.
Maybe you're independent, you can submit on your own, or you can submit as a group of up to 3 people, okay? So check it out, and also make sure you subscribe to this channel for new science videos every Thursday. See you.